Have you seen this girl? She went missing about a week ago.
Hey, Joe, you seen this girl?
Take a few extras to give to your neighbors.
Kev needs your help. I need your help.
I only risk my life for family.
He is my family.
All right, YouTube. This is the preview. Season 3, Episode 3, The Shy. In these videos, when I do these trailer reviews, I slow down the trailer itself. See if we can pick it apart for clues in the upcoming episode. I do this with your help, so I need you guys to leave me your comments on the different things that we see in this trailer. This season has really felt heavy after only 2 episodes. A lot of different perspectives going on. A lot of people have their hot takes on some of the, I guess, the sexual scenes in here, but we're just gonna break down this particular trailer, pick it apart for clues. If you're finding me for the first time, please subscribe to this channel. Be sure to check us out live Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 9 p.m. Me and the fellas, we go live to discuss not only The Shy, but other subjects that are plaguing America. We do some stocks investing. We do a lot on the live show. And also, if you guys been following me for a while, some of you guys know I'm getting ready to have a kid next week, and I will be chronicling what I go through as a father, raising a child, being a stay-at-home dad, from fitness to making money, and I also get some footage of the baby being delivered, so check that out as well. And without further ado, let's jump into it. Let's watch the trailer one more time, and then we'll pick it apart.
Have you asked God for forgiveness?
I don't know how.
Keisha has been missing for 7 days. If we don't bring her home soon, there's a chance that she won't be found alive.
All right, first scene we see Little Miss Massage Booty, Jada, putting up a missing Keisha poster, and she looks very concerned in that scene. And at this point in time, I guess the whole city is on alert now. They know Keisha is missing. Then we see, I think this is Kev and Keisha's stepmom out here on the streets. You see she's got that fanny pack on her chest and she's got that watch. That looks like her style, asking people on the street, have you seen this young lady? And I've been wondering, when was Emmett gonna find out? What was gonna be Emmett's response? So you see him here and he looks real concerned on the streets, asking people, trying to get people to help him out, let them know what's going on. Then we see Keisha's mom talking to somebody in the hood. And ladies and gentlemen, if you grew up in the hood or anywhere on the South Side, most places in the United States, you know that a lot of people in the hood have this code where if it's gonna involve the police, we ain't doing no talking. And this little soap opera watching brother looked like he is just like that, where Kev's mom is like, brother, help me out. If you've seen something, you know something. And he's basically walking away like his ass is about to go in there and watch Young and the Restless, punk ass. From there, we get Trig talking to Kev and Jake. I guess the mystery of this scene basically for me is, okay, Jake and Kev get driven to school by Duda every day. Why did they run to Trig before they go to Jake? And basically what they're saying is, you know, Keisha's boyfriend was some kind of a gangster. And Trig is basically at first saying, you know, I only help family. Jake saying Keisha's family. Kev gave a real deep heart speech about, hey man, I mean, I can get out this car right now if I'm wasting my time. But I think the question for me is, why did they not go to Duda? Are they trying to show a building in the relationship between Jake and Trig? Or do they just feel like, you know, Trig got more pull on the streets because he just got out of jail? I don't know, but I'm interested to see how this works out, because Duda might be mad if he finds out that Jake is fiddler-daddling with Trig to do some street stuff. And from there, we see Trig roll up on a little gangster that's supposed to be Keisha's boyfriend and pulls a piece on him, puts it right in his chest, then they walk his ass in the house, put him on his knees, and then some of y'all gonna have jokes about this, but Trig's girlfriend pulls out her piece, and I'm strictly talking about gun piece. I know some of y'all minds is going 4 different ways when I say a piece, like she got 2 pieces, but I'm talking about the gun piece. They got his ass on his knees, and basically, I think they're gonna search this home, and Keisha is not gonna be there, of course, and there's not gonna be any remnants of Keisha. Next, we see y'all's favorite character, old rusty-ass Ronnie, pushing his grocery cart, running from somebody. And I mean, he ain't doing Usain Bolt speeds either. That boy is going slower than a train at 3 miles an hour. And then we see what I think they want us to think is Rusty Ronnie getting beat up. And I can't tell who's beating him up. And I can't tell if that's Ronnie. But if I had to guess, I think that's Ronnie. I don't know who's beating him up. And after that, the very next scene, we see someone fixing up the cuts on Ronnie, which is why I think that's possibly Ronnie in the previous scene. But the question here is, where is Ronnie? Who's fixing up his cuts? You see this big brother with these broad shoulders fixing his cuts. And I'm gonna assume that this might be someone in a church, a pastor, someone that might works in the church, because everybody know all about Rusty Ass Ronnie in the city. That's why he's getting beat up and can't walk nowhere. And whoever this person is not holding judgment on Ronnie, and they're helping him out. And then we see what they're doing. It's like a lighting of a vigil for Keisha, where you see all these people in the city, and you've got somebody up there doing a speech. I can't really tell who that is. I couldn't zoom in close enough for that. We see Kevin walking in, and you know, he's kind of got this look on his face like, man, let's keep hope alive. You have the young lady up there giving a powerful speech. I can't wait to hear that speech. Then last but not least, you see Rusty Ass Ronnie pull his ass up there with the cut on his head, holding a candle. And I think that this is gonna be his mission for this episode, to find Keisha, to vindicate himself, to get back in the good graces of the people of Chicago. But ladies and gentlemen, I just do not think we're gonna find Keisha. I personally think Keisha is dead. The rumor on the street is she wanted to get paid more money, so she's not gonna be back. And that makes me sad. She's a North Carolina native, right up the street from where I live at. One of the most beautiful people on this show. And I guess I'll just have to do some digging and figure out where she's going and follow her on something else. But leave me all your comments. What did I miss in this trailer? What did you see? What are your predictions for episode 3? Be sure to follow me and the fellas live Monday, Wednesday, and Friday night at 9. Check out my other channel, the Life Game Reviews channel. That's where I'll be putting all the baby content. That's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to like the video, comment, subscribe. Get yourself that life game. And until that next Sex Is Hell video, I'll see you.